Good day to all of you. In the previous class, you learnt about the formatting bar and the file menu. As you all know, in the first class of the week, you learn something new and then in the next class, you revise what you have learnt. So in today's class, you will revise what you learnt in the previous class and then you will learn about some parts of the edit menu. Can you tell why we use the formatting bar? With the formatting bar, you can do all types of formatting on your text or paragraph like bold, italics, underline, changing the text style or changing the color of the text. Can you tell why we use the new option? With new option, you can bring up a new page or a new document. You can bring up many pages, new pages, and do many types of work on them. Can you tell what happens with export as PDF and what is the full form of PDF? With export as PDF, you can convert your document into PDF format. This makes your document secure. Now, no one can do any editing on the PDF document. You can only read such documents. And the full form of PDF is portable document format. Can you tell why we use recent documents? With the recent documents option, you can view the files that you had recently opened and can work upon them. Can you tell what is the difference between slide pane and slide layout? Slide pane is in the left side of the impress file, where you can see all the slides and you can move from one slide to another as you want. Whereas slide layout is on the right side of the impress slide, where you can see and choose different types of layouts and you can change the way the slides look. Can you tell what happens with exit? With exit, you can close your file and get back to your desktop. Now, all of you switch on your computers and by the method taught to you, open the impress file. Let us now begin today's class. Let us first know what we will learn today. You will all type out a line and then copy paste it. After that, you will learn about undo, redo, cut, select all, deleting a slide, and about find and replace. Then you will practice some of the file options like converting to PDF, saving a file, and using the formatting bar. So let us start today's class. First, all of you type out the given line. Have you all typed out the given line? Next, all of you copy paste this line 5 times. You have already learned copy paste in the writer module. If you face any problems in doing the copy paste, then watch the video and learn. With the help of this video, let us now see how we can use copy paste on our slide. So since we already have a line which we have typed on our slide, we want to copy the same and paste it many times. So let's first click on this line. You will see a box appears and now you go ahead and select the line. Select it by any of the methods which you know. And now, since you have to copy it, bring your pointer to the Edit menu in the menu bar and left click on that. When you left click, you see a box opens up with options available. So click on the copy option. Once you click, you will see that no change happens on your slide, but this line has got copied. Now, since we want to paste this, we will use the same method. We will bring a pointer to edit and click on the paste option. However, first we need to see where we are going to paste this line. So in this box, let's press enter once so that we come to a new line. Then go to edit, select on paste, and you will see that the line gets pasted. You press enter once more, and now you can use the shortcut method for paste, which is Ctrl plus V. Remember that to copy also, you can use the shortcut command Ctrl plus C. So like this, we keep on pressing enter after every line, and we can get many copies of the same line pasted on our slide. Have you all completed the copy paste? If not, then watch the video again. Now you will learn about undo and redo. Can you tell why we use undo? Undo is an option by using which you can correct any mistake that you may have made on your page or slide. With undo, you can delete one by one the last lines that you had wrongly typed. The shortcut for this is Ctrl plus Z. Come, let's watch the video and learn to use the undo option. This video teaches us how to use the undo command. With undo, we can go one step back, or in other words, the last line that you have typed can be removed by using undo. So to do undo, we take a pointer to the edit option in the menu bar and then select the undo option, and you will see that the last line gets erased. Once again, if we go to edit and do click on undo, the other next line, the second last line which we have typed or copied or paste it, also gets removed. We can also use the shortcut command, which is Ctrl plus Z for undo. So now we do Ctrl plus Z, and you notice that the next line or the last line also disappears. So this is taking us one step backwards. Like this, if we again do a Ctrl plus Z here, the first line, very first line which was there in the slide, also gets removed. So this is how you use undo to go one step backwards. Can you tell why we use the redo command? Redo is the exact opposite of undo. Whatever you deleted by using the undo command and later want to bring it back, then you can do so by using redo. The shortcut command for redo is Ctrl plus Y. Let us now watch the video and learn to use redo. Let us now see in this video how we use redo. Since redo is the exact opposite of undo, you can only use redo if you have already used the undo command. So now we have only one line on our slide because by undo we had removed all the lines. Now go to the edit menu, click on that and click on redo, and you will see that the next line which we had undone comes back. Again go to edit and click on undo, redo, and the next line will also come back. You can also use the shortcut command for it. And you, as is being shown in the video, which is Ctrl plus Y, and you bring back the lines. So So this is how you will use redo. Now you all will revise some of the options of the formatting bar. Go ahead and show how you will change the writing style of the first line. If you face a problem, then take the help of the video. Let us now practice changing the font name, or you can say changing the writing style. So if we have to change the writing style of our slide's first line, we first need to select the text. When we click on it, the text box appears as is being shown in the slide. Now we need to select the first line because we have to change the writing style here. You can select this line using any of the methods that has already been taught to you by using the mouse touchpad or using the shift and the arrow keys on the keyboard. So after selecting, bring your pointer to the font name drop down, and when you click there, you see many fonts are available, different writing styles are available. If you scroll up and down, you will see many writing styles which are already predefined as writing styles or font names are available. Click on the one which you like and you will see that that writing style gets applied to the line that you have selected. Now make the second line bold and italic. Again, if you have a problem doing this, with the help of the video, this video will help us practice how we can make our line, selected line or text, bold. So for this, we need to first select the line as is being shown in the video, select the second line, and then take the pointer to the formatting bar where B is written and left click on that, and your line becomes bold. If you click here in the text area, you will see that the line has become bold and the selection will go away. Now if you want to make the line back to normal again without bold, you'll need to once again select the line and then take the pointer to the B option again in the formatting bar and click there, and you can see that the line becomes normal once again. Since you want to make it bold, let's select it and click on B to make it bold. Next, select all the lines and underline them, and then go ahead and change their color. If you face a problem, watch the video and learn. This video will help us practice underlining our text and also changing the font color. So if you want to underline some text, you need to first select those lines that you want to underline as is being shown in the video. Then take your pointer to the formatting bar where the U button is there and left click on it, and you can see that your lines get underlined on your slide. Now if you want to change the font color, bring your pointer to the A option in the formatting bar and click on the down arrow, and you will see a number of colors are available. Click on the one which you like, left click on it, and that color gets applied on the text that you have selected. To see this, go back to the text area and left click there so that the selection gets removed and you can see that the font color has been changed. Let us now learn about find and replace. You have learned about find and replace in the writer module. Can you tell why we use find and replace? With find, you can search for any word in your paragraph. And with replace, you can replace that word with a word of your choice. Let us watch this video and learn more about how find and replace are used. With the help of this video, we are going to learn the use of find and replace in our text. Since we want to do find and replace on the text, we first need to select the text so that the text box appears. Bring your pointer to the edit option and then click on find and replace. A box opens and the word that you have to find, you have to type in the search for box. So bring the pointer in the search for box, left click on that so that the pointer starts blinking there, and then type the word that you want to search in your text. Let us type the word mission so that we want to find the word mission in the text. Now when we click on find, the first time that the word mission appears in our text gets highlighted. Again, if we click on find, the next word mission gets highlighted, and so on till all the words get highlighted. Now, since we need to replace this word with a different word, we have to type the word with which we want to replace the word mission in the replace with box. So bring your pointer to the replace with box, left click on that so that the cursor starts blinking there, and then type the word, let's type vision. So we want to replace all the mission words in the text with the word vision. Now when we click on replace, the first time that the word mission appears gets highlighted. And then when we click on replace, it gets replaced by vision. Once again, if we click on replace, the next word mission gets replaced by vision. And if we click on replace all the words mission in the text get replaced by vision, as is being shown in the video to you. Now, if we want to bring back, if we want to search for mission again, and if we click on find, you will notice that no word is found. As is being shown in the video, there is no word mission now in the text. So now let's search for the word vision and replace it back with mission. So here in the search for box, you will type vision, and in the replace with box, you will type mission. We are just finding the word vision. As is being shown, it gets highlighted. And in the replace with box, we are now typing mission, because that was what the word was originally. And then when we click on replace, the first time that the word vision appears gets replaced by mission. If you again click on replace, the second word also gets replaced. If you click on replace all the words vision get replaced by mission. You can close this box for find and replace after you have used find and replace. Next, bring up a new slide and make the drawing being shown to you. If you have a problem in doing this, then watch the video and take its help in drawing the picture. With the help of this video, let us now take a blank slide, draw one of the basic shapes in it, and format the same. So to do this, we first need to take a new slide. So click on the slide pane and then click on the right button. Click on new slide and you will see that a new slide is available to you. Since we have to draw, we go to the drawing toolbar. We select one of the shapes, whichever shape we like. Circle, ellipse, diamond, when we choose the parallelogram shape. So we click on that, then we come to our slide and drag here so that our image of a parallelogram is made. Now to do the formatting, you can see that the filling toolbar and the line options are available. So we go to the formatting toolbar, boundary line options, and click on the boundary line that we like, and that gets applied on our drawing. Next, we can change the width of the boundary line as is being shown in the video. From the up arrow, we are increasing it. And from the color option, by the drop-down box, you can choose by scrolling up and down any of the colors that you like. So, the boundary line has been changed to pink. Now, to color inside, let us this time choose the hatching option for filling in color. So, when you click on the drop-down box here, you see number of hatching options available. So, you can select the one which you like as is being shown in the video to you. This is how we can make any changes on our slide. Next, use copy-paste to make a copy of this picture. Again, learn from the video if you face a problem. Now, let's also see how we can copy-paste more of the same image on our slide. So, since we have to copy this particular drawing from our slide, we must first select it. We have to click on the image to select it, as is being shown in the video to you. Then, we take our pointer to the edit menu of the menu bar and click on copy. Now, since we have to paste it, let's see what happens if we paste it at the same spot. So, we go back, take our pointer again to edit menu and click on paste. So, now, if you go to the image and click on it, and then while you keep the mouse or touch button, left button pressed, drag it, then you will see that the image which has been pasted on top of the original gets dragged and shown. You can drag it anywhere that you like. So, this is how you can copy paste your image on the slide. You will now learn about cut and paste. Can you tell why we use the cut option? With the help of the cut option, you can cut a line or a picture from its present position and then paste it at a position that you want it to appear. Now, all of you go ahead and cut out any one picture from the second slide and paste it on a new blank slide. In case of a problem, learn from the video. With the help of this video, let us now see how we can use cut and paste. So, to cut, we have to cut from the second slide where you see two images as is being shown in the video. And to cut, you need to use the edit option of the menu bar. However, if you click on edit, you will see that the cut is not highlighted. Because to cut something, you have to first select it. So, we come back, bring our pointer back to the slide, and we first need to select it by left clicking on that slide. Now, we go to the edit option and we can use the cut option here, or we can also use the shortcut command Ctrl plus X to cut. So, we click on this option with our mouse or touchpad and the image you can see has been cut. Now, since we have to paste it in a new slide and click on with the right button, you will see there is an option of paste in the bottom. However, you can also use the edit command and go and click on edit and click on paste. So, you will see that our slide gets pasted. Now, again with the left button keeping pressed, you can drag this image where you want it to appear. This is how you can use cut and paste option on your slides. We will now learn about duplicates. Do you know what are duplicates? As you can make out from the name, duplicate means being exactly like the original. Using duplicates, you can make many copies of any of your pictures or drawings. Let's watch the video and learn how we can use the duplicates option. With the help of this video, we will now see how we can get duplicates of our image or make more copies of the image which are exactly the same. So, like in the video, we have been shown our drawing. If we want to make a duplicate of it, we must select it. And then notice that if we go to the edit menu without selecting, the duplicate option is not highlighted. So you first select the image as is being shown in the video, go to the edit menu, and then you can select the duplicate option which is highlighted here. Click on duplicates, click on this option, and a box opens. This has many options for the duplicates. First option is for the number of copies. What it means is how many copies of that image do you want? So let's say if we have selected 3, then towards the bottom you see the colors of the copies. So you can select the color of the copy that you want to start with. For instance, when we click on the pink color to start with, and then in the end, we want the last image to be, let's say, of the color green, and you can click on green. Then we will go and click on OK, and you will see that your images are made available to you. So the first image is pink and the last is green. Let us now practice export as PDF. So now, all of you go ahead and show how you will convert your file into PDF. If you face a problem, then take the help of the video being shown to you. Let us watch this video to see how we can convert our file to PDF format. So to convert a present file, which you can see in the title bar, it is an untitled file. To convert it to PDF, we take our pointer to the file option and then select the export as PDF option. Once we left click on that, a box opens which has many options for PDF. However, right now you do not have to make any changes to any of these options, and just look for the export button at the bottom and left click on that. Another box opens which allows you to say where you want to save this file as PDF and by what name. So you can use the address bar on top or the address box on the left side to define where you want, whether you want to save it in downloads or documents or music or videos. So since we want to save it in desktop, we will select desktop. Then take your pointer to the file name option. And if there's something written already, you can use backspace to delete that and type a name with which you want to save your PDF file. We are typing CS, and you can see as save as type is shown, portable document format. Now click on save and your file gets saved in PDF format. Currently you can see in the video, this is still the untitled file which is not saved. But once you press on minimize option, you get to the desktop and you can see here that your PDF file named CS is saved here. If you double click on it, it will open up and you can see that all the slides of your PDF file are contained in this PDF file. You can scroll down and see the other slides are also available in this PDF file. So this is how you can save your file to PDF. All your slides, all your file gets converted to PDF. You can close this and from the taskbar, click on the file again to open your original file. Now, bring up a new slide and make one of the basic shapes by yourself and then show how you can do formatting on that. Now you will learn about delete slide. Do you know why we use the delete slide option? You can delete your slide by using the delete slide option. Now go ahead and delete any one slide. If you face a problem, watch the video and learn. In this video, we will learn the use of delete slide. So if we want to delete any of our slides from our presentation, Impress file, we need to select that slide. So as you can see, there are four slides in our file, as is being shown in the video. And we want to, let's say we want to delete the last slide, the fourth slide. So we click on the fourth slide and so that the fourth slide appears here. Then we take our pointer to the edit option and select the delete slide option. As soon as you select delete slide, you can see that the fourth slide now gets deleted. So this is how you will use the delete slide option. Next, go ahead and save this file with your name in the document folder. Again, if you have a doubt, learn from the video. Watch this video to learn how to save our file. So to save our file, we need to first take a pointer to the file menu in the menu bar. Left click on that and from the box which opens, click on save. And another box opens where you can say where you want to save this file. So in you can choose the address bar, you can choose desktop. Since we want to save it in the documents folder, we will click on documents, then go to file name, and you can delete anything which is already written there by pressing backspace. Type your file name like CS and then click on the save option. This will save your file, as is also being shown in the title bar here, as is being shown in the video. The file has been saved by the name of CS. So this is how you will save your file in the documents folder. Since this class will end here, close your file and properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you all learnt about undo, redo, cut, copy, paste, find and replace, and about delete slide. And you also practiced some of the options of the file menu like save, export as PDF, etc. Thank you.